31. As we continue our journey, let's be alert and attentive to what the Holy Spirit has to say to us personally. With the help of Saint Joseph, let us search and find out the areas which need our undivided attention. Insofar as our bond with our wife and our children is concerned. When a family comes together, shouldn't a sense of joy and freedom prevail? Let's meditate on this. Reflection. I am the head of the family, so everything here should be within my personal control. Whatever happens in this family should only be according to my plan and purpose. Do we men have such notions? If yes, doesn't it reflect our arrogance and pride? Let's examine ourselves. Is this the main cause of disagreements and disputes in our family? Let's get rid of the belief that a father is one who has to rule over every other member of the family. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility, regard others as better than yourselves. We read in Philippians chapter 2, verse 3. If we are filled with love, it becomes easy to humbly regard the spouses as better than ourselves. Then and only then can we fathers seek, regard and value the opinion of our spouse and children. Have we given our wives the freedom to express their opinion? Are we able to accept and implement their suggestions, though different from our own? Though the father is the head, by making decisions as per his own whims and fancies, there is every chance of relations falling apart. Taking the example of the Holy Family, in the Bible, we do not read about any tiffs or arguments between Joseph and Mary, because each one regarded the other as better than themselves and looked into the interests of the other. There is a story, whether true or not, we are not sure, but it does throw light on the Holy Family as a model for all families to follow. A passerby once walked up to Joseph working outside the house and asked, "How is it that your family is so peaceful and happy? How do you keep it so?" Joseph replied, "Oh, it's not because of me. It's because of Mary there inside, and of course our son Jesus." It is said that the passerby went into the house and found Mary hustling between pots and pans. "Your husband out there tells me it is you that keeps this family joyful. How do you do it?" "Oh no, not so. It is our son Jesus and my husband that keeps our family joyful." The man came to Jesus. "Can you please tell me, how do you keep your family cheerful like this?" "Who, me? Not really. It's not me. It's my mother and father who are to be given the credit that we are happy and peaceful." A family that prays together, plays together, will surely be happy. Prayer. Abba Father, help us to be loving and respectful towards every member of our family. Saint Joseph, pray for all of us fathers that we do not lord it over the other members of the family, but treat them with love and esteem, humbly accepting and valuing and their ideas and opinion. Activity. Daily spend at least some quality time with your wife to talk and share about the happenings of the day.